Sure. I learned to take pride in my ancestors who built the railroad. My popo would make me a hot bowl of yolk and thousand egg eggs after the white kids chase me home from school yelling boop, chink,
okay, okay, that's enough.
Painful to listen to, isn't it?
Look, I don't know what kind of bullshit ethnic studies program they're running over in Madison, Wisconsin, but did they teach you that in order to find your Asian roots, it's a good idea first to be...
Are you speaking metaphorically?
No, literally! Look at your skin!
You know it's very stereotypical to think that all Asian skin tones conform to a single hue.
You're white.
Is this some kind of redneck joke? Am I the first person to tell you this?
Oh.
Relations are scarce in the Midwest, but
Jesus.
I see where your misunderstanding arises.
Yeah, it's called you're white.
Well, you see. Back in my hometown of Tribune, Kansas. You see, everybody knows me, so this sort of thing never comes up. Benjamin Wong. I forget that a society related to racial constructs constantly forces me to explain my very existence. Ryan Chen, who was known as the Bowman. You see, I was adopted by Chinese American parents at birth, so clearly I'm Asian American, even though you're blonde and blue-eyed. You can't judge my race by my genetic heritage. Genes don't determine race, what does?
Brother, I'm just trying to figure out what you already got.
What do I got?
A home with your people picketing with laundry workers, taking refuge against the daily slights against your masculinity, all in the noble image of one home.
One who?
The Chinese god of warriors? What are you taking me for? There's altars to them all throughout your community.
I don't know what community you're talking about, but it's sure as hell not mine.
What do you mean?
Like, if you want to call Chinatown your community, okay, knock yourself out. Learn to use chopsticks. Try to find your identity in the dimps in the bar with all the stuff hanging in the window. Those places, they don't tell you a thing about who I am.
Oh, I get it.
You get what?
You're one of those self-hating and simulated Chinese Americans, aren't you?
Jesus.
Bet you thought yourself Oriental, right?
Listen, I have some books that might... You know, I read all those books where you were still slathering on industrial strength sunblock. Sure, I'm Chinese. Folks like you act like that means something, like all of a sudden, you know who I am. You think identity is that simple, that you can just say, I have ethnicity, therefore I am? Like fucking ethnic fundamentalists, looking for the easy answers. You say you're trying to find identity, but you can't even begin to face the real mysteries of the search. So instead, you go skin deep, call it a day.
So what are you saying? That you're just a human being? That's like saying you have no identity at all. If you'd ask me to describe my dog, I'd say he's more than just a dog.
So you're saying if I deny the importance of my race, I'm nobody? There are worlds out there. Worlds we haven't even begun to understand. Open your eyes. Hear with your ears. I can see this was all filled long ago. But that was even before the birth of jazz, when the hollerings in the fields, the rank injustice of human bondage, where God's children struggle against the plagues of the devil's white man, when all these boiled into that bittersweet brew, all by later generations of blues. When the coming of rats on the different pioneers stuff spit, he sang as he stroked the catgut, singing with that rasping Louis Armstrong voice. Like rough and sweet timber riding on horses south of the Timberwolf. And finally had to sail to Europe, finding fierce and here. Europe, where Stefano Pelli edition of magic French violin to be passed from generation to generation. Now tell me, is there any legacy as rich, as culture, as layered with mythology and heroes to inspire pride? What can I say if the banging of the bell or the clinking of a pickaxe on the transcontinental railroad fails to move me so much as one note? Something like the violin meeting the killer of the tower of God. Does it have to sound like Chinese office for people like you decide that I know who I am? Thank you.
When I finally found 13 Doyer Street, I scanned the buildings for number 13, walking down the alley with a scent of freshly steamed cha-cha bar lingering in the air. I felt immediately I had entered a world where all things were finally familiar. When I saw number 13, I nearly went to my good fortune, an old tenement. The walls peeling, the paint, the walls covered with centuries of grease and broken dreams, all the hope for a better life. I could see it all. Gong-gong coming home from 16-hour days of precious certs he can never afford to own, bringing home little candies, all with the hope of a better life for my dad. When my father left me go, he swore he would never return. But he had this day, the thoughts and memories of his son. As I sat on the stoop, I pulled a pomade from my pocket, and sucked on it and felt his spirit returning to me. To the place where his ghost and all his descendants would always call home. And as I sat there, I felt an ache in my heart for all those lost souls denied this most important of all revelations. To know who they